Landing pages are one of the core pieces of the HubSpot software. So let's go through setting up a landing page for the first time.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
A landing page is a type of web page that has one central purpose, and it allows the user to know exactly what's expected of them, whether that's downloading an ebook or registering for a webinar, or simply taking an action where you, as the user, can capture their information, whether that's an email or a first name, last name company. You control the form on that page, as well as the overall experience. So let's dive into HubSpot and see how to set up for the first time. To get to landing pages inside of HubSpot, you're gonna be under this marketing tab, website, and landing pages. And you're gonna end up on a page that looks like this. So if you're here for the first time, you're actually going to have a page that looks more like this. We have a sample that's published on here. This is our test portal. And so you won't have anything really to choose from here like we do over in the portal that's already active. But I'm gonna create a landing page. And when you have a new portal, you can either have your landing page styled to match your blog, which is done in the HubSpot onboarding process. If you're not sure what HubSpot onboarding is, we have a different video you can check out there. But inside of HubSpot here, you have all of these templates that are kind of just off the shelf. So you're gonna have different styles here based on the needs that you have. So you might have one, this one has like a photo behind it. This clearly is an ebook download. This one that says, you know, vast two column landing page, you might have an event where this is like the event details. So the best use of landing pages as you go forward is going to be to create a look and a feel that's consistent with your brand and also has a good user experience. So we're not gonna focus too much on the user experience or the design in this video, but we're gonna focus on just getting the page set up and going through the fundamental actions you need to make it live and then embed the form or whatever action it is with that landing page. So here in this this interface, we're gonna select this vast three column. Again, this would be a great one to use if you had an ebook. So we'll choose this. We're gonna name the page. We're just gonna call it ebook download for now. This is the name that you actually use inside of HubSpot. So again, if your team is using a bunch of different landing pages, you know what the page is about. So here's a little quick tip. You might wanna actually use some sort of naming convention that allows you to know what type of page you're creating. Because when you create a landing page, a best practice after someone downloads your ebook is to always have a thank you page. So at SimpleStrat, one of the things we do is we use LP underscore to signify that it's a landing page. And then we also insert version one or version two so that if we, again, update it later on down the line, we still have record of previous versions. So I'm gonna create this page and it's using that template that was already in HubSpot. So here, this is the preloaded content that came in from that that template. So this, if you're using a template that's already built inside HubSpot, this section here where it has a little lock on it, that's gonna be edited over into the content editor. But for now, we're not gonna focus on that either because we wanna really just get this landing page up. If you've done the onboarding and you've gotten all of your landing page and like the footers and the menus at the top styled, these parts should be set. So we're not gonna pay attention to that right now. So here I'm gonna update this to whatever the name of the page happens to be. So it might be, you know, download the marketing ebook. And then here, if this was something where I actually had text about the ebook, I would add that here. If I wanted to add my own custom image, I can change this out. And then again, add a new image using this insert image. In a different video, we have instructions on how to add a video into a landing page. If you wanna do that, you would insert video here. Otherwise, we're gonna assume that this is okay and then go ahead and save that. So your sidebar form, this is the most important part of a landing page because the form is what you're using to capture that information. So then it goes into HubSpot and you can actually deliver that asset to the person after they have registered. So to actually do a form inside a landing page, you have to have a form built first inside of HubSpot. So I'm gonna select a form, and right now we've only got one form inside of HubSpot. This is, again, our test portal. So we'd have to go and create a different form. So I'm gonna show you what this looks like inside of our portal. We've already got a lot of forms that are built, and we can make a little bit easier navigate. We can navigate around a little bit easier for you. So I'm gonna use one of our templates here. Let's scroll down to this. We have an ebook template that we've already had created. I'm gonna call this ebook test because it's in our live portal. So because we've had this landing page already styled, again, we've gone through the process of setting this up, each time we have a new ebook, we simply change out some of the text, we change out the image, we change out the copy, and we can have a shell to use going forward. So if I wanted to change this image out, I would. Here we're gonna focus on that form. So I have get your guide, and then first name, last name, company, and email. So when I say select the form, all of these forms are gonna pop up as to the forms we have available inside of HubSpot. So I'm gonna jump back over to that test portal, and inside marketing, you have lead capture and forms. So I'm actually gonna save this real quick before I leave so I don't end up missing this screen. We're gonna go to lead capture and forms. So a real quick thing about forms, we'll have a different video you can watch about forms because there's HubSpot forms and not HubSpot forms, but right now what we're doing is we're creating this form inside of the HubSpot portal to use onside of our landing pages. So we have regular forms, and that's gonna be what's embedded on that landing page. So I wanna say next. And I wanna start, so they're gonna ask you, do you wanna start with a blank template or do you wanna have something again over here? HubSpot does a great job of giving you like, you know, kind of starter things you can use to start the process. Event registration, we're talking about an ebook. So I'm gonna use this ebook download and it's gonna suggest that you use email, first name, last name, and phone number. So real quick tip, the more forms you have on a page, the less likely, or more form fields you have on a page, the less likely someone is to fill out that form. But the more forms you have that qualify that person, sometimes you get better leads from that form. So if you want more advice on that, I encourage you to do some research on just number of form fields and conversions. But we're gonna click start on this. So again, this is my form fields. And I've got email, first name, last name, and phone number. And up here is the name of my form. So I'm gonna call this ebook download form. And here I've got options. If I wanted to add some new fields in here, so let's say I wanted to add their city. I would just drag this over here into this section and I can add their city. Now I've got five fields. And I can even change this word on the submit. So let's say the word is, you know, get your ebook now. And that's what that button would now say. So I'm gonna remove city because we only want four fields here. And then I'm gonna click on publish. Actually, one quick thing on options. One of the best practices is for you to have a page that they go to as a thank you. You'll set all of that up over actually on the landing page. So you don't have to worry about this right now. And then style and preview, you can change the way your button looks and you can change the way that your font looks. So go ahead and dig into those features. We're gonna go ahead and click publish here. So that is our publish. And I'm gonna X out of this. Since it is published, I'll see it here in forms. I've got the ebook download form. So let's go back to marketing. I'm gonna go back to website and landing pages. And let's go back to that landing page we were just working on. So I'm gonna click on edits. All right, so we've got this sidebar form and I'm gonna click into this here and I'm gonna change this form based on the one we just created. So here we have ebook download form. Awesome. And if I click save, looks like my thank you message. I'm gonna redirect them to another page. So here would be if I had a different page. So this might be, you know, the thank you page. We don't actually have a thank you page created just yet. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna jump out of here. We're gonna save this again. I'm gonna go to marketing and landing pages. Let's create one more. And we're gonna create a thank you page. And here's a thank you page that's in the template. So thank you ebook, thank you page. And again, if this page, if you're working on this, you know, thanks for downloading this ebook. You would customize this graphic here, you'd customize the text. A best practice on this page is to maybe suggest another piece of content that they might like be interested in, or you simply have a link to download the actual ebook on this page, just in case they don't happen to get that email in their inbox with the link to the ebook. So best practice, offer that ebook on this thank you page. And again, this menu up here to be set up if you go through the customization process of customizing your templates and click save. And then with each one of your landing pages, just like you optimize for your blog posts where you have the title, you have the description, you have a specific URL, you want to do that here in the settings of every type of landing page, whether it's a thank you page, an ebook page, an event registration page, you always want to make sure that this settings page is set up so that, again, if someone lands on that page, at the top, it doesn't say sample thank you page. It would actually say, you know, thank you for downloading this ebook. And then publisher schedule. When I go back to that landing page we were creating together and I see the first, and I see the chance to say redirect to another page, if my thank you page is not live, I can actually not select that. So we're gonna publish this live right now. I'm gonna publish now. Oh, and it's gonna tell me that my HTML title is required. So thank you for downloading this ebook. Save, publish on schedule, and then I'm gonna publish it. So we will publish now. All right, so this page looks similar to the other one. Now that it's live, this is a screen that you will see once you start to accumulate data. It's gonna show down here at the bottom. Let's go back to our landing pages and let's select the one that's still in draft mode. All right, so we're gonna edit this form over here. The form title, I'm gonna call it Download This Ebook, and that shows right above that form. I've got the ebook download form. When the visitor submits the form, I want them to redirect to another page. And that page I'm selecting is this thank you page we just created together. And if I want to view and test that link again, this is a good just reminder. Every time you're creating a page, you want to double check each step of the process. And then send form notifications to specified email address instead of the form defaults. So when we set up this ebook form, I'm gonna open a new window and actually show you something real quick here. When we opened, or when we created that form, the form defaults are going to be in those options settings of the form. So here in the options setting, it said send email notifications to, and this is my email. This is gonna be the default. So when it asks you, do you wanna use the default here, if you don't toggle this on, then whatever email is in this form setup is going to be the one that gets notified that you've gotten a new download. If you toggle this on, it's going to ask you to select a new email address of the new person. So let's say you want two people to get it, and then you would have both of those people here. So this add to workflow allows us to set up a workflow that actually delivers that email, or you can click on send a follow-up email. And that's a really simple way here to get that email delivered right on your first landing page. We're gonna actually set up a workflow instead because it's a little bit more powerful. So we're gonna untoggle this, click add to workflow. We need to go actually set up that workflow. So I'm gonna click create new. And this workflow is going to be called ebook delivery. And I'm gonna create that. It opens a new window for me. So here in this automation, I'm gonna set my enrollment trigger, and my enrollment trigger is going to be a form submission. And my form submission here is this ebook download form on, and basically I can choose whatever page I want to, but this page, I want that ebook page, which and actually for this to show up, you actually have to publish that landing page. So let's go ahead and publish the landing page. It's a little backwards. We'll call this ebook download. I'm gonna save. And then we're gonna publish this right now. Okay, so jumping back over to this ebook delivery on any page, it's not gonna be live because I just did that, so let's actually just refresh this. We're gonna refresh this workflow. All right, ebook delivery, set on an enrollment trigger of, let's go to form submission, ebook download form on. And here we go. This is our landing page that we just talked about. There's other things here, like if you have a date or it's in between certain times, we're going to keep it simple. So done. All right. So do I trigger this automatically? You want that to be yes, because anytime someone downloads it, you want them to go ahead and have that triggered. So here's our trigger criteria. Let's say that you want to add another, like if this or that, you could add some more conditions here. And then this box here would be if you want to enroll anybody who's already met this criteria. In this case, you would not. This one's here, important, change enrollment options. This would be if like someone comes back and downloads this ebook again, you would enroll them again. So basically I always fill this on because if they've come back and got the ebook three times, you don't want them to not get the email to get that ebook. So I'm gonna click save. So they fill out this ebook and now they get the email sent to them. The workflow right now is off, and so I want to go ahead and take a next step into settings. It's going to run 7 days a week, any time of the day. The performance here, this is, again, if people are downloading your ebook, you should be able to see the performance of this particular workflow, and then there's a history. So I'm going to review it, and then now I will turn this on. So this is okay, it is on. All right, so I'm going back to this download or this landing page to download the ebook. This is our final step. And we have this form. Everything hinges on this form. Again, that's our form name. We've selected the ebook download form. We redirect them to another page. Once they've gotten that form submitted, they go to the thank you page. We send the form notifications. So both Allie and Tyler will get a notification when someone downloads this ebook. We're gonna add them to a workflow. This is the workflow we just made, that ebook delivery. We're gonna click apply. And then we're gonna go save and go to module list. So now, since we already published this ebook page due to the workflow need, you'd go back and make sure and fill in these things. Customize your URL here because this is gonna be important in sharing that URL. You want it to not be a bunch of characters smushed together. And it's gonna update now. You've already published it, so we can go ahead and see that live. So we're gonna update this page now. And this now is your landing page. So I should be able to go in here, add my email. And click your ebook now. There you go. So this is your thank you page. Again, if you added this, go ahead and get the ebook. You've now got to the thank you page. I should go ahead and get a ebook delivery email in my inbox. And it looks like it is right there. So that's it. That's how to set up a landing page in HubSpot. For more HubSpot hacks, how-tos, and tips, go ahead and hit subscribe on that channel button, and we'll be coming at you each week with more on HubSpot. If you have any questions or comments related to this video, drop them in the comments below. We read each and every one, and we'll hopefully be able to address your questions or comments in a future video.